Okay, today we are going to study ETA. That means emergency towing appliance. This emergency towing appliance is mainly for tankers whose dead weight is more than 20,000 tons. Okay, so if the dead weight is more than 20,000 tons, it must have one forward ETA and one aft ETA. Okay, so the function of ETA is to prevent pollution and assist in towing in case of any emergency, and reduce risk of pollution. That is the main thing. Okay, that's why it is designed for only for tankers. Okay, and so since we discussed, since I told you about the forward and aft ETA. And the aft ETA, there is some criteria. It should be able to deploy within 15 minutes by one person. Okay, it's everything in aft ETA is pre-rigged. Okay, pre-rigged means it is already rigged in such a position. One person with 15 minutes, he can deploy the ETA. Okay, and it is so designed that without power ships, for even if the ship has no power, like electricity, then no power, then also one person can operate. Okay, normally if you go to a tanker, you can see aft ETA gears are kept inside a box, which is very close to the ships aft railing. Okay, this is aft railing, this is aft railing, this is the stern, or you can say transom and propeller, like this. Okay, and for the extension of the ETA will be like this. Okay, this is a winch with wires coiled on it. Okay, so what happened is, when one person comes and open this box, cover of this box will fall down like this. So this cover will come down like this. Okay, so this cover will come down like this. Okay, whatever ropes and things are, which is stored inside, it will fall down on the water. Okay, so this rope is fitted with a buoy, with self-floating and a self with the lights on. It will automatically ignite when the buoy is on the water. So the water, when the ropes falls on the water, this buoy will float above the water surface. So if any tugboat comes for assisting the stranded vessel, the tugboat guy can easily pick up this buoy. This buoy is connected to this rope, and he pulls the buoy inside, and slowly, slowly he pulls the rope also inside. That rope is called pickup gear. Pickup gear. Okay. So after pickup gear is on board the tugboat, there will be one strong rope. Okay, that strong rope he'll attach to his tugs bollard. Okay, now the tugs will start pulling. So whatever co ropes left inside this box will also get stretched out. Okay, so when the tugs pulls and it gives a minimum pull, this rope is attached to the wire. This wire is coiled in a drum, and this drum is secured with a link. We call it as weak link. Okay, when tugs gives a jerk, this weak link will break off, and then the tugs can pull out the entire rope coiled on this drum, and entire rope wire rope will fall into the water. Okay, at the end of the wire rope, there is a locking arrangement. Okay, that locking arrangement will, for example, this is the fair lead through which the wire is passing through and pulled by the tag. Okay, from this side the drum is there. When at the end of the rope, there will be a locking arrangement which is made up of metal, or locking system is there. Okay, so that locking system will lock the wire from further going out. Okay, so there will be a locking arrangement also fitted on the deck. Okay, that is stationary, and when the wire pass through, that will pass through this small hole, and at the end of the wire, this locking arrangement will be there. This will come and struck there. Okay, so the when the tug pulls further, this wire will be stuck there, and it acts like a strong point. Okay, so this is how the aft ETA works. Okay, the next one is forward ETA. In forward ETA, forward ETA, it is actually there is some allowance. So the one it is such a heavy equipment, in the forward bow side, mainly it's a huge chain. Okay, it is huge chain. Okay, so to deploy in this forward, it is a big task. So it is not able for one person, and it cannot be done within 15 minutes. So some time allowance has given, that 1 hour time period is given for deploying this forward ETA. Okay, and there are certain procedures how to deploy this forward ETA. So mostly in the forward section of the ship, along with the mooring winches are here, and there will be some chains which is secured on the forward deck only, and they are used for ETA purpose. Okay, so this forward ETA, because there are two ways you can deploy using ship's power and tug's power. Okay, so when first I will tell how to deploy with the ship's power. Okay, in ship's power, what we do is, so here there is a chain, and this is the bow, and one salvage tug is here, and okay, she say, I am not going to pull down your chain, you give me your rope and you have to make it properly. Okay, so in this method, what we do is, we will pass a line. Okay, line which is the chain is having only a few meters of length. Okay, so we will tie up a rope. Okay, rope, polypropylene rope or wire rope. Okay, and we tie up one rope with this thing, and that polypropylene rope is almost 76 cm, so you cannot throw that rope to the ship, this tugboat. So what we do is, one we attach a polypropylene rope here and keep it coiled on the deck. At the end of this polypropylene rope, we will tie one messenger line. Okay, we will tie one messenger line, and that messenger line will pass through the fair lid through which the ETA has to be passed. Okay, then one person standing here and collect enough slack on the messenger rope, and he throws that rope to tugboat by guy will pick up that rope. Okay, he will pass it through the bollard or his fair lid. Okay, for example, he collect his and he pass it through, he one person will pass it through his fair lid and pass it around his roller pedestal or something like that, and take that point tip out. Okay, now what the ship's crew has to do is, ship crew has to send one heaving line. Heaving line, okay. Heaving line will tug buoy will again collect, and he will collect that connect that heaving line with the messenger rope, ship's messenger rope, which is already passed through the tug's fair lead and roller pedestal or the puller. Okay, now the ship's messenger line is connected with the ship's heaving line, but it is passed through tug's fair lead. Okay, now what the ship's crew will keep pulling this heaving line up, so the entire messenger line will pass through the tug's fair lead, and the one end of the messenger line will reach the ship's reach on ship's deck. Now this messenger line is heaved using ship's winch, so the ship's winch will keep pulling. So the messenger line is connected to 76 mm per towing rope. So this 76 mm towing rope will go out of the ships and finally reach the tug's towing arrangement system. So one that tug will put that 76 mm rope on the tug's bollard. Okay, once everything is finished, the tug will disconnect the messenger line, the ship's crew will pull out the messenger line and the heaving line back on board. Once everything is, when the ship and tugboat reaches an agreement, then the tugboat keep pulling. So this 76 mm rope will stretch out, okay, slowly, which all the line, all the chains which are there, that will also stretch out and pass through the ship's fair lead. And normally this forward ETH chain will only reach up to a few meters outside of the ship's forward fair lead, and this chain will be connected to a strong point in the forward side. Okay, so this is how forward ETA works. Okay, and now we will talk about the requirement of a towing arrangement system. So towing arrangement system must be capable of withstanding certain amount of load on it. Okay, so load or power, pressure or whatever we call it as in kilonewtons. Okay, so for a ship of 20,000 dead weight to 50,000 dead weight, and the towing arrangement should have a bollard pull or breaking strength of 22,000 kilonewton. Okay, that much breaking stress, it is the minimum required. Okay, and for a ship up to 20,000 must have a breaking stress of 1,000 kilonewton. Okay, this is the requirement for the ETAs on board ship. Now the towing components. So towing ETA means emergency towing arrangement. So this ETA is having lots of components attached to it that I already described in the previous just few seconds ago, but I will discuss again in for one more time in a proper way. Okay, now the forward ETA and aft ETA. Okay, so always aft is my favorite because it is 15 minutes deployment, and it is an easy way, and but because of that easy arrangement, it has more components. Okay, so aft ETA is having what we call it as a pickup gear. Okay, pickup gear, and next one is towing pennant and chafing gear, and when we have fair lead, it is required because without fair lead rope cannot pass. Okay, and a strong point. This is where the strong point, this play a very important role. Okay, and after one is roller pedestal. This roller pedestal in some ship it may be replaced by winch. Okay, but just for your information only. Now the forward ETA. Forward ETA must also have one pickup gear. Without pickup gear, how the tug will pick up? Okay, so pickup gear is there. Okay, now towing pennant. This forward ETA don't have. Forward ETA don't have. But chafing gear is there. Now parallel is obviously it is there. Okay. Now strong point also has to be there. Okay. Now roller pedestal. It is must for the forward ETA. Why? Because you have to pick up the line using tug, from the tug. In the aft ETA, you don't have to pick up anything from the tug. You just open the box, everything is already on the water. Tug guy can create pick up that buoy from the water itself only. But in the forward case, you have to pick up the line from line which is passing through the tug. So if you are using ship's power, then this roller pedestal is must. Okay. So I have seen in some ships this roller pedestals are not given. In some ships roller pedestals are given also. But if roller pedestals are not given, then you can use the ship's forward winch. Forward winch for this purpose of picking up the rope from the tug. You use the forward winch and warping drum and use the pickup rope. So roller pedestal is not given, you can use this thing. Similarly, in aft also, if roller pedestal is not given, you can use the winch. Okay. So these are the parts of the ETA. Now ETA, I told you everything about components, and now let's have a discussion about the strong points and failure locations. Okay, strong points. Strong points and failure location. So strong point for aft ETA, it will be kept on aft. Okay, forward, if you go to forward, there will be two strong points on the forward side. Okay, so basically two sets of forward chains will be given. Okay, so this strong point has to be parallel. The strong point with through which only the line will come and pass through the fair lead. Okay, so this axis of the strong point with the fair lead must be parallel to the center line. Okay, suppose this is the center line, it must be parallel to the center line. Okay, now here is the forward fair lead, this is the strong point, and the chain will pass through like this. Okay, so this axis must be parallel to the center line. Okay, and the distance between this center line and the towing line axis not to be greater than 1.5 meters. Okay, so maximum the distance between center line and towing line is 1.5 meters. Okay, so this strong point must be designed in such a way that the tug must be able to do the towing either from the port side of the vessel or from the starboard side of the vessel. Similarly in the aft, so it must be either from the port side of the vessel or aft starboard side of the vessel, the tug must be able to do the pulling. So it must be in that arrangement. Okay, so the strong point will minimize the fairly and strong point will minimize the stress on the towing system and all those things. So ship, that's the purpose of the strong point and fair lead. Okay, now strong point is there. Now the towing pennant. Okay, so towing pennant is the we can simply call it as a rope which is required for the towing of the vessel. Okay, so this towing pennant is actually connected to the ship and tug for pulling. So for towing it should have enough length so that tug can tug will have enough space for maneuvering and pulling. Okay, so this towing pennant must have a length. Okay, minimum length. Okay, for example, this is the ship and this is the keel. Okay, so this is our draft. Okay, summer draft. Okay, so the towing pennant will go like this and connect it to the tugboat. Okay, so that this length should be minimum. Okay, minimum. I am talking about the minimum length. Okay, so minimum length must be 2 into height at light ship ballast condition. Okay, light ship ballast freeboard. Where are this pen? Okay, suppose this is our light ship condition draft. Okay, so what is the freeboard here? This is, this much is the light ship freeboard, right? So this this height into 2. Okay, let's say h, this height into 2, light ship ballast freeboard height into 2 plus 50 meters, this must be the length of the towing pennant. Okay, so that is the requirement for towing pennant. And if we are talking about the fair lead, now the fair lead must be on an oval shape. Okay, fair lead must be in an oval shape. Okay, so the if so oval shape means length is one size is different, it is not a circular. Okay, so one of the side must be 600 mm, that means minimum 60 centimeter wide, and the height must be 450 mm. Okay, so that is sufficient enough for passing all the towing pennant and all the ropes and everything. Okay, so that is the dimension required for the towing fair lead associated with the towing arrangement system. Okay, now it must be designed in such a way that, okay, for example, this is our, I am just drawing like this. Okay, and normally this towing, this fair leads are not, doesn't look like our normal fair lead. Okay, they have an curvature like this. Okay, from the ship side. Okay, also if you look from the outer side of the ship also, this fair leads will come like this only, little bulged outside. Okay, so this fair leads will okay, so rope will pass through smoothly without damaging any of the adjacent structure. Okay, so this fair leads are designed in such a way that, suppose this is our towing rope. Okay, it must be able to the wire must be able to the outside of the ship. Okay, pass, oh shit, suppose if the tug wants to be in a direction 90 degree from the ship's forward, that is either port side or either starboard side, 90 degree from the ship's bow, so the rope will go like this. Okay, from the fairlead like this. So it should be, the fairlead should be designed in such a way that the rope will pass through like that, then still the pallet should be able to support the towing. Okay, that is the way the pallet should be designed. Okay, now and this is one side angles. Now the vertical angles. Okay, in vertical angle that pallet must be this is the vertical. Okay, from the pallet 90 degree down and 30 degree. Okay, normally tug will keep a this much angle like this, but even if the tug want to, if there is a rough congested area, tug don't have enough space, tug will come little closer and try to pull like this. Okay, so directly weight is coming on the pallet. Even at this small angle the tug should be able to operate, the pallet should be designed to take that much of stress. Okay, that is the chafing the pallet's location. So this is the dimension, this is actually the geometry it has to be designed, and this is the vertical and this is 90 degree. Okay, 90 degree, and this is 30 degree vertical location. This must be very close to deck, chaffing engine to be parallel to deck. So aisa nahi hona chahiye, this is our strong point, this is our main deck, the this is our pallet. If it is like this, this is our chaffing chain and everything will pass like this, that it should not be like that. The position should be the pallet should be almost close to the deck, so that the whenever a strong point is there, when the chain is passing attached to the strong point passes through the pallet, it must be parallel to the main deck. Okay, this is the position of the pallet. Okay, now the another part is chaffing chain. Okay, chaffing chain is normally 76 mm diameters. Okay, okay, then and now the length now will is okay, if the towing parent remains outside the pallet and extend from the strong point to a point 3 meters beyond the pallet. Okay, so chaffing chain should be just like I discussed a few minutes earlier. So chaffing chain will only remain few meters outside. Okay, this is the chain. Okay, okay, so the chain will be initially connected to the ship using a strong point. Okay, so and it will pass through our pallet. Okay, this pallet and this outside the pallet, the chaffing chain should have a minimum of 3 meters. That is the length minimum required. Okay, and that's all about the chaffing chain of the ETA. Now another thing is maintenance. Okay, maintenance of ETA. Okay, so what my suggestion is, every time you go for a mooring station forward or aft, you visually check whenever you take your mooring winches, try out for your mooring winches. Normally you have plenty of time once you are at the mooring station, you till the time you are cast off. So you check the all the forward and aft ETA during that time only. Okay, don't wait for the routine maintenance. Okay, no, okay, still there is a maintenance schedules for this ETS. Okay, there is a weekly one, 6 monthly one. Okay, 2 yearly one. Okay, in the weekly one is check all the components in all places. Subtick here, everything is there in that place, none of the pieces or none of the components are missing. Okay, check all components. Okay, so this this routine will come under your Saturday routines normally in some ships. Okay, Saturday routines. Saturday routines for deck department. Okay, now this 6 monthly routines. Remember I told you in aft ETA there is a flashing boy, self igniting flashing boy when lowered in the water. That boy is having a battery. Okay, that battery needs to be changed every 6 months. Okay, so change boy battery. Okay, now every 2 years, very important, because this thing, because we are, since you are doing only after 2 years, lots of importance must be given. Okay, so every maintenance you do in this 2 years has to be given special detailed attention, because the next maintenance you are going, this set of maintenance you will be doing is after, again after 2 years. Okay, so whatever maintenance you do, you do it devotionally and dedicatedly. Okay, because your the next 2 year life of the ETA depends upon the job you do this today. Okay, so greasing the wire. Okay, the for aft ETA is having a towing wire that has to be greased. Okay, so that it they don't rust. Okay, remove the brake and cleaning the aft ETA having a winch. I told you that winch is normally fitted with the air motor. Okay, air motor, using that air motor the winch can be operated. Okay, so that winch is also fitted with the braking system. So that braking system, that brake assembly has to be removed and clean it. Okay, and check the condition of the brake, then you refit. Okay, remove the brake and clean it. Okay, two yearly, and then aft air motor check. So I told you check. Oh shit. Okay. Check air motor. Now the ETA will be secured with the strong point. If I tell you, normally strong point is actually a big pin sort of arrangement. Okay, in some ships. Okay, this is your deck. This is the hole. Okay, this is also a hole. Okay, so one big pin will be there, one end will be closed like this, the pin will pass through this thing, and one locking pin is there, the chain will be attached to it. Okay, so if you remove this pin, then you can remove the entire locking system, locking arrangement. So this locking pin has to be checked. Okay, so these are the maintenance. So weekly maintenance, 6 monthly weekly maintenance, 6 monthly maintenance, 2 year weekly check all the components, change the battery 6 monthly, grease the wire, remove clean brakes. So simple. Okay, so that's all guys for ETA.